Dear friends, greetings to all. Today's topic is measures of central tendency. This is in the sixth chapter of the subject business statistics. Measures of central tendency means that is a measure to know the one number from the mass data. As you know that the data are collected and it is in raw form. Then it is classified and tabulated based on that diagram and graph are drawn. And these tables or diagram or graph won't give a complete clear picture. It may give some clear picture about the character of the data, but if it is presented in one number only, it is giving a clear idea, Okay. For example, that students in colleges, say students in colleges are around 1,500 or 1,000, 2,000, in some colleges 2,700. And students are studying. If a researcher wants to know the English knowledge of the students in these colleges of near district, say he has selected 7 colleges. And collected data related to their score in the plus 2 level English subject. And there will be in 2000 number is there in colleges, 2000 students are there, then 2000 numbers are there. But whatever it may be, it is tabulated or not, and then it may not give a clear picture. Tabulated also. But if it is taken as one number, as average, total of the 2000 divided by 2000 will give one number. That may be, say, for example, 73 in one college, in another college 67, in another college 45. Thereby, we can come to the conclusion that, so this college is better with respect to English. This is not much better, need further coaching for improve the English standard. Okay, this and for the measures of central tendency, there are three types of measures are there. One is the mean, second one is the median, third one is the mode. First one, mean. In mean only some divisions are there. Median and mode are very simple, so no divisions there. First, see the mean. The mean, there are three types. One is arithmetic mean. Second one is geometric mean. Third one is harmonic mean. Most commonly, arithmetic mean is applied or used by concerns. For example, arithmetic mean is just totaling the variables, whether it is income, marks, expenses, whatever it may be, quantitative value, and after totaling, the value should be divided by the total number. Suppose there are 2500 variables, the 2500 variables should be totaled and divided by 2500 to get one number, say represent the whole data. Okay, then in the individual observation, discrete series, continuous series, different formulas are there. Then second type is geometric mean. This is somewhat the proportionate value of the variables is derived, and this is based on the logarithm. The logarithm value of each variable should be calculated, and it will be totaled, and average should be calculated. Then anti-log of that number should be calculated. Okay, then third one is harmonic mean. In the harmonic mean, the proportionate value, inverse value of each variable to be calculated. That means inverse value means 1 by x. So that one mark means 1 by 72, like that. And that by taking the inverse value, then it would be totaled. And n by that total of the inverse value. That is a formula for the harmonic mean. Harmonic mean is normally applied when the averages, when the variables in different situations are differing due to the some nature. For example, a bus is traveling with the speed of first 10 kilometer at the rate of 50 kilometer per hour. Then after from 10 kilometer to 25 kilometer, the speed of 63 kilometer per hour. And after that, it is going with the speed of 73 kilometer per hour. If that kind of calculation is there, recording is there, then this harmonic mean is better measurement to find the average of that. Okay, these are all related to mean. Second one is median. Median is the mid value of the variable. The variable should be arranged in ascending order or descending order. Let us take, say for example, 11 students in a class, for example. And the 11 students' marks according to a serial number, it may be varying. First one may be a score of 74, second one 35, third one then 95, like that. But we should arrange it from the lowest to high and find the mid value. In the 11 students means 11 plus 1 by 2, that is 6th. The 6th mark will be considered as the median. Then third one is mode. Mode is the most frequently appearing item in the series. The number I recorded highest number of time is considered as mode. For example, in the class of 100 students, the marks of say 64 repeated many times. 64 repeated 12 times, that means 12 students scored 64 marks. And 59 marks repeated for 7 times. And say for example, 90 marks repeated for 4 times. Like that it was means, then that 64 marks is considered as the mode of the series, since it is repeated highest number of time, that is 12 number of time. Okay, that's all about the measures of central tendency. Then about the illustrations, separate videos will be released. Okay, thank you very much.